Hey y'all, how's it going? Today we're going to make a beautiful, about 2.5 pound bone-in ribeye from QC Meat Market, Port Avenue, Corpus Christi, Texas. They have an awesome selection over there of Mexican cuts and American cuts, Angus, the whole shebang. But anyway, I picked one up and I had taken it home and sealed it in a bag and put it in the freezer and got it out. And we're gonna season it up. We're only gonna use salt and set it out, let it do its thing. Then we're gonna cook it over on the, Joy charcoal stove. I'm so used to using the PK grill. The Joy charcoal stove, it's another good contraption. And then we'll see how it comes out. So let's get started on prepping it up, okay? Without further ado, let's get started. Well, here's our subject right here. Beautiful ribeye, bone in, lots of marbling, about 2 inches thick. Comes from QC Meat Market, Port Avenue, Corpus Christi, Texas. We're just going to take some plain Jane sea salt in this grinder. We're going to put it on the lowest setting and just let it have it. Put a lot. It's a thick piece of meat. Like I always say, when it's thicker, put a lot. All it's going to do is draw the moisture out and help us get a crust later. Okay. Pat it down, flip it. Okay. And then you can kind of rub it on the board and get what's left. Picks it right up. Just leave it here. Let the salt and the meat get to know each other. And you can leave it there for at least 1 hour, but you could leave it there 2, 3, 4 hours, whatever you want. The salt's going to draw the moisture out of the outer layers of the beef, and that'll help us sear it, make a nice crust. All right, let me go get the Joy charcoal stove ready in about a half hour. I'm gonna let this go for about an hour at least. See you out there. Okay, we got the Joy charcoal stove here set up. It's a great piece of equipment. Too bad we can't find them in the United States. No how. I got the grill grates on there. I got some B&B lump coal in there, red hot. We're gonna just put this baby on there. We'll just start off at an angle like this, okay? And that's a 2-inch piece of meat. If we sear it in here and we get all the way to the end and it's still not where I want it, guess what? I got this going. I got some sweet potatoes in there in aluminum foil. So we can always bring it over here and do a little bit of baking. We'll see what happens. But just put it on there and just let it go. It's not going to catch on fire. It's too thick. All right, then. All right, let's give it a flip. I don't know how long it's been, but about, I'm going to say 4 minutes. Grab it and flip it. There's our grill marks, looking good. They're not black, but they're brown. Brown is good too, folks. And it's nice and, it's got a good bark on it, man, honestly. So we'll go this way now, and we'll come back and flip it again. Okay, it's been about 4 more minutes. Let's go ahead and flip it again. Like that. It's cooking. It's got a good crust. It doesn't have the beautiful grill marks, but remember, that's cosmetic. It has a crust though, man. That's what I'm talking about. I want a crust. The grill grates, they're an accessory you can get for your any of your pits. All right, so we'll let it go on this side, then one more flip, then we'll... All right, let's give it its last flip. Got an awesome crust on here, man. We might not have to put it over there, to tell you the truth. We'll see what happens. But we'll just do this, and then we'll let it rest, and give it a slice. We might even taste a sweet potato while we're at it. All right, then. Okay, shall we take it off? Let's take it off now. Take it off and let it rest. We'll let it rest for a few minutes up on here. I think it's done. I don't think we need to smoke it. So we'll put it on here, let it rest, and then we'll slice it and commence to tasting it, okay? Should be nice and salty, if nothing else. All right, man. And I think it's select, but who cares? Big chunk of meat like that, it's got to be good, folks. Got to be good. All right. All right. The time has arrived. El steak, el sweet potato. Start with el steak. And the elf flies, get out of here. Look at them, man. You know things are getting back to normal if the house flies are back. Cuts good, very tender, very pink on the inside. Probably about medium. Let's see what we got here, folks. Let's see what we got here. Just start right here. Oh yeah. Pulls apart very nice. Mmm. Oh man. QC Meat Market. Y'all got the good meat, man. Mmm. It's like 5-something a pound for bone-in ribeye. That's unheard of. I don't know what it is now. That was a couple weeks ago. Perfect. Mmm. This is good. And like you saw, I only put salt. And the salt's only on the outside. The salt's only on the outside, so you get a nice heavy dose of salt when you bite into it, but then all this part you just taste meat, man. Mm-mm. That's what I'm talking about. All right, well, here's a little piece of sweet potato. You know this is good. Oh man. Not even funny. Skin comes right off. You just throw it. The critters will get it. They're starving right now anyway. Mmm. Let's try a piece of the ribeye more on this side. Away from that. You know how it has a sweet spot or whatever they call it? We'll try over here. Try this little piece first. Mmm. So good, folks. I better stop. I gotta split this with my wife. I'm gonna get carried away and eat the whole thing. Mmm. That's killer. And these sweet potatoes are killer. I got 4 of them. Mmm. what I do with the sweet potatoes, I wrap them in foil, put them in the PK grill and just let them bake. Then at the end, when the fork went through them, I took them out of the foil and put them right over the coals and just let it crisp up the outside. Came out good, man. All right, y'all. Thanks for stopping by. Please subscribe, comment, like, hit the little bell and hit all so you can get the notifications. And like always, God bless you. And we'll see you next time. Adios, amigos.